Now you can get the same uncompromising truth you've come to expect from the Final Call newspaper on all your connected devices. Subscribe to the Final Call Digital Edition today. Go to subscribe.finalcalldigital.com.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, we forever thank Allah for his coming to the black man and woman in the hells of North America in the person of Master Farid Muhammad and raising in our midst the Messiah, the Christ, the eternal leader of the Nation of Islam, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. We thank them both for the Jesus in our midst, our light-giving son, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. I greet my beloved brothers and sisters in the words of peace. Assalamu alaikum. Today is Friday, July 31st, 2020. Last week, we entered into Study Guide 17, Hypocrisy and Conspiracy, where we are encountering the plan by the imposter Jews to put Jesus to death. By now, you should have completed your reading assignment from last week, so that we can dive into the discussion tonight. It is in this study guide where we receive our spiritual immunization from turning Judas. Unlike the four study guides before it and the one that comes right after it, this study guide has no introductory letter from the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. He is silent. Everything in the reading assignment is taking place in real time. He gives us a list of selected verses from selected chapters in the Holy Quran for us to read and study, beginning with chapter 9, verses 43 to 59, where Allah is telling his messenger how to identify through their behavior those among his followers that are hypocrites. The God talks about how they sow seeds of dissension, devise plots against him. They hate giving charity. They don't like prayer. They're lazy. They are fearful of the opposition. When good befalls the messenger, they grieve. And when hardship afflicts him, they rejoice. And then we are instructed to read the last five chapters of the Holy Quran. All of them are very short, between three and six verses, with most of the verses consisting of only one sentence. Chapter 110, The Help. This was revealed at Mecca 80 days before the end of the Prophet's life. It celebrates the triumph of Islam in the whole of Arabia. It speaks of men entering the religion of Allah in companies. Some of us interpret that as being the mosque, but it does not say coming into the mosque. It says coming into the religion of Allah. The 40 to 60 million descendants of slaves in America are coming into Islam in companies. This is why Satan is in discomfiture. He cannot stop it. Chapter 111 is the flame. It deals with the end of opposition to the truth. Chapter 112 is the unity. These verses we recite daily in our prayers, and Maulana Muhammad Ali says that this is actually the concluding chapter of the Holy Quran, giving the sum and substance of the teachings of the book, which is the unity of the Supreme God. And it reads, "Say he, Allah is one. Allah is he on whom all depend. He begets not, nor is he begotten, and none is like him." The final two chapters are actually prayers. They are our refuge prayers, which we need now, beloved, more than ever. This is our protection from the evil of the envier when he envies. And just a little preview, if you have not read this study guide before, it will be envy that plummets the nation into darkness. Finally, the Holy Quran ends with the prayer where we seek refuge from our greatest enemy of all, the slinking devil in our own mind. May Allah bless us. May He protect us from the evil of intense darkness when it comes. Now, this reading is serious, but it is necessary. Be joyful that the criterion is among us. Be joyful that we have truth in our midst in a man, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. May Allah bless us with a wonderful evening. Assalamu alaikum.